Hey everybody, how you doing? It's OCD Mikey Boy here, and I've got another installment of the Crazy Cracker sitting in the COVID dungeon, pulling his hair out. Well, I actually haven't pulled my hair out. You should see how long it is, man. Damn, I can almost do a ponytail. I'm looking rather scraggly. Anyways, so here we are. Open Baffle Project. We're going to run through a couple of the drivers, the full range drivers. As you can see, I've got in there right now, those are the Tang Band. Let's see if I can get the model number for you. Tang Band W8 1808. So that is the Tang Band driver in the full range position. Down in the 21, it's a Dayton Audio. You can find that at Parts Express. So I'm telling you how to build these things if you want to. You just make a flat baffle, put a stand on it, cut two holes in it, put those puppies in there, and then the key part is the first watt B5 open baffle crossover. That thing is like crucial to the whole project. Something about what Nelson does in there really makes the bass come alive, and normally it's really hard to do bass without at least some sort of, you know, some sort of a, I don't know, chamber or something around it. I mean, with this one's not designed, this woofer is not designed for open baffle, so it's even tougher to get it to do bass. So anyways, that Pass Labs B5. And then, so we're going straight out of the DAC, which has a volume control, straight down to the B5 crossover, which you see down here. So we're going from the DAC to the B5, straight out to dual amplifiers. Because it's a, you know, you're going to use an active crossover, that means you're going to use two amplifier channels on each side. So I've got a stereo amp on each side. Right now, they are Jeff Roland 625 S2s. So roughly 320 watts. Class AB per side, more than enough, and to mosey us on down the road. So let's listen to what I've got now. Now I had some super tweeters that we put in a while back. They're up there. I've disengaged those so we can just really hear the 21 and the open baffle. That's what we want to hear. You can always add a super tweeter in, but let's in order to hear the differences of the real differences of the 8-inch drivers, I want to take that super tweeter out because that'll help us. We can hear the differences, like which ones do treble better, you know? So I'll start out with a couple tunes here and let's see what we got. I'm digging into the history here a little bit. So here we go.
Oh, mama, I'm in fear for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman is putting end to my running and I'm so far from my home. Oh, mama, I can hear you a-crying, you're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from the gallows and I don't have very long.
If you want to add bass to this even more, okay, let's say, then what you have to do is attenuate those, the high, or the full range, you need to attenuate those down a little bit. So I'm going to cut out, I'm going to take negative 5 dB out of those full range now on each side so we can see how it sounds when I do that. Before you could be too harsh. Okay, so let's click into another tune. Hold up, let me get it. Hold on. Okay, here's a little something for ya. Don't do this at home. It's actually a great test for your rig. Here we go. Thing's pretty wicked, intense stuff. Gustav Mahler, Symphony Number 6 in A minor, tragic finale, allegro moderato. Okay, so let me see. Let me hit you up on another tune. Hold on, because I got to start changing speakers. Okay, here we go. And I can't do like every single genre type. We're gonna do three songs. We'll do these three songs of each. You know, but maybe well, that's all right. Here we go. Nope. Wait, that's not it. No, that is not the one that I want. Here we go. A good example of a killer wicked full recording. I mean, that recording has got some serious dynamics, got great levels and everything. You saw it first, we had to turn it way down, man. It was just totally intense. So keep in mind, you know, we've got $17,000 amps on each side. So I mean, these things are just, oh my god, hats off to Nelson Pass on the first Watt B5, because that makes this thing all possible. I tried it with the Marchand underneath. That tube on Marchand did not cut the turkey at all, man. It actually kind of blew compared to the Nelson steel, okay? Now, Nelson's crossover is purposely made for an open baffle. That's why it does so well, because it has all these little things, you know, in there, settings and so forth, to make up for the inadequacies of an open baffle. So it does a phenomenal job too. I mean, really, really, it's a killer little piece. And then of course we're using a $22,000 Playback Designs MPD-8 Dream DAC. That is my reference. I've spent years and years, over 15 years, to find that DAC. And I think I've found my stopping place. I don't think I'm going anywhere from here. I don't have any desire for a DAC anymore. The DAC whole notion thing on my mind is gone. Thank God, because it was a heavy one there. You know, I mean, DAC, make no mistake about it, the DAC sets the bar for your digital rig, period. No matter what anyone says, the source is not that important. that damn little streamer, you can put almost anything with a kick-ass DAC like this, and it's going to sound phenomenal. And I'm going to show you guys how to make a DAC, just like I'm telling you right now, how to make these damn open baffle speakers, if you want to, for yourselves. You go to Parts Express, you get yourself a Dayton Audio 21. You go to some local guy who makes cabinets and have them cut you and with the CNC, or you make your own, man. Get a whole jig and a router and cut yourself a 21-inch hole, cut yourself an 8-inch hole, stuff what we just listened to now is the Tang Band. What is it, 108 or something? I gave you the numbers earlier. But so now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pull out these Tang Bands and I'll put in a Visiton, which is another, you can get all these things at Parts Express. Visiton, and let's listen to that. And then I've got a surprise coming up. So hold on.
Oh mama, I'm in fear for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman is putting an end to my running and I'm so far from my home. Oh mama, I can hear you a-crying, you're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from the gallows and I don't have very long.
Those things are pretty kick-ass, man. Those are the drivers that I just picked, you know, visually from looking, you know, at the little charts and shit. I picked these two drivers to go together, and I think they were a killer match. I had those Tang Bands on hand from another pair of speakers, and they were just sitting here, and so I thought I'd put them in just to compare. And they're great, but I think these are awesome, man. I mean, these are really super quiet, you know, and killer. I dig these things. Anyways, okay, so next, tune. So let's move on to the next tune. And remember, we got to turn it down a little bit now because this one is a very, very strong. Let's see. Okay, right here. Ciao.
Waiting for
two-way. Right there, man. That is a MF and two-way speaker, friends. You don't need no subwoofer. We don't need no stinking sub. We don't need no stinking sub. We don't need no stinking tweeters either, really. Honestly, it's fine without them. We'll try them later with if you want. Well, okay. Okay, why don't I do it right now? Because actually, this is going to end. This is going to end these speakers because I got the surprise for you that I told you about. So let me go ahead. Let's see, these are off right now. Let me go ahead and put some Super Tivita in here. See how we like the two, the Super Tivita. I think we like the Super Tivita. I do. It give us good shimmer, the symbols. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so we got that side hooked up. This one's a little bit more funky to do, but I shall get it. Let's see. Okay. What a pain in the ass neck. Don't ask what an ass neck is, because I'll have to tell you, it ain't pretty. See, this time, I'm going to make you guys do all the grunt work with me and see all the behind the scenes grunt work that I do for you guys so you can have a cool experience changing out all this shite. I think I want somebody to send me a plate of brownies. I think I deserve it. Okay, let's see. Yeah, we got them pinched right in there. Okay, turn that puppy on. Okay, we'll give her one click. Okay, so now let's listen to that tune that we just heard. Let's see if we get something unique and different. Frosting on the cake, yeah, for sure, man. Yeah, that lights her up there. Puts a little shimmer on top, shimmer frosting on top. I dig it. I'm digging it. That sounds good. Let's go again. Let's listen. Oh, that bass is so good. That's so juicy and tasty. I just want to take a bite out of it. Damn. Okay, that's awesome. Man, we are cooking with fire now. Okay, but I'm going to take those Super Tweeters back out because I have got a surprise for you. I've got some AER drivers. I've got some handmade in wherever the hell, Germany, I believe. These things that are... They're retarded expensive. They're like $3,000 each, okay, for these things. Of course, I got them for half that, but still, AER Mark I. These should do much better highs. We might not even need the super tweets. Let's listen, and I'll bet you, well, let's just listen, because this should be a much refined, this should be the cat's meow, really. And unfortunately, that hole doesn't fit it, so I've got my trusty Dremel, and I'm going to have to on these things right now to make those fit for you guys so I can play the damn music. But I want to do it anyway, so I'm not going to make you guys, I'm not going to make you guys sit and watch me Dremel the stuff, because it will be very boring, and it'll be like a dentist drill. So I'll be back. Hold on. It's going to seem like 1 second, and it's going to take me like an hour, but that's okay. You guys are worth it. Okay. Hold on. Okay. So I'm back. I've been sweating for the last hour. I got these things fit in there nice, and wow, that's all I can say about these puppies, man. What a difference. You get what you pay for. That's all I can say. All right, let's listen. Here we go.
Oh, mama, I'm in fear for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman is putting into my running, and I'm so far from my home. Oh, mama, I can hear you crying. You're so scared and all alone.
I didn't change anything on the crossover settings at all.
Hangman is coming down from the gallows, and I don't have very long.
Yeah, so I actually want to listen to it now, whereas before I was like, I got to shut it off because it was just kind of too harsh. So these things are just way more smooth, way more refined, better top end. I mean, can't you tell? You got it. I mean, it's night and day difference between these and the other ones. Wow. Okay, let me find this again. So, totally different. Couldn't you hear much better into the music? Like, so much better into the music. This is unbelievably, that's a perfect example of the difference between high quality and regular quality. I mean, you can hear so much more of the music in these speakers. All the little, and the tone and the timbre of the woodwinds and everything is just so correct. You can just hear it all. You miss all that stuff in the other ones. The other one's probably good for rock and roll, you know, maybe. But I mean, even the rock and roll got better. So let's try our last tune. And then we might play around, do some other things over here. Okay. Turn it up a little now. Oh, yeah, they go nice.
How nice to have you here.
Dude, I'm going to launch into a listening session after this and just close my eyes and kick back and just assimilate into my environment. Wow. Okay, so that's the good shit. Can you tell? I mean, can you tell? You got to be able to tell. Well, I hope you're using headphones, because you need to be using headphones for this. Honestly. I know you can probably hear it on your rig, but if you want to hear it the best, put headphones on. That is such a good example of the difference between a killer driver and an okay driver. Look, man, I mean, you heard how these things sound. You have no idea. If you were here, the depth of the bass and everything is so nice and coherent and everything. And dude, meanwhile, there's like Magico out there that has, like, you know, they're pitching their damn quarter inch thick aluminum box, and I've got a slab of freaking plywood, man, showing you that electronics mean everything. The cabinet doesn't mean shit. I mean, look at this. On a slab of freaking plywood, I've got the, you know, a cheap ass 21 inch, and I've got a kick ass 8 inch, and kick-ass electronics, and you don't need no stinking cabinet, no damn, you know, aluminum box. Give me a break. For 50 grand, 40 grand, 30 grand, these speakers are, let's see, with these $3,000 drivers, so there's, say, six, this is maybe a $7,000 speaker, your cost if you build it, you know, with those drivers. You know, you get it for a little bit less, maybe five or something like that. But I mean, this is the shit. I mean, there's no, you can't deny, if you sit here, that this is moving. It's totally moving, totally engaging, totally just so good.